Salutations, everybody, and thank you for watching VintageNewscast.com. I hope everyone is doing well, and I have a very special treat for you today. I want to share with you my experience at the Madame Tussauds House of Wax. I have a lot of footage to show you. It was an amazing experience. Wow, I really did enjoy myself, and I'm very glad I decided to go. My journey started off at the 9th floor, and I walked my way down to, I think, about the 3rd floor. It was like a maze there. When I walked in, you know, you'd never think that the place is so huge, but it is very huge. And when you look up, the ceilings seemed like they go on forever. It was like being in a castle. Now, to my understanding, they had about over 200 plus waxed celebrities and historic figures there. Some of them looked very real. The detail of these wax figures were phenomenal, down to the hairline. It must have cost thousands and thousands of dollars, literally, just to create one. The artists and the people who sculpted these figures are truly talented. It was well worth visiting Madame Tussauds. Now, some of the figures, in my opinion, didn't look like, some of the wax figures didn't look like the person that they were supposed to represent. For instance, Oprah, in my opinion, did not look like Oprah. Then again, I realized, you know, it may have depended on the year that they sculpted her, because we all know Oprah has changed tremendously throughout her career. But judging how Oprah looks today, the wax figure representing her did not look like her, in my opinion. The way they did her hair made her look more like Donna Summers, I was thinking. You know, remember in the very late 90s when she came out with a hit song, I'll Go With You, in that video? That's exactly like the style of the hair that they made her. If I remember, I'll try to find a picture and show it, you know, beside her so you can see what I'm talking about. So, you know, I hope you guys don't think that, you know, I'm crazy. Although I really, really enjoyed myself there, I also felt very weird. Those of you who've been at the bodies exhibit may understand exactly what I'm talking about. Keep in mind again that these wax figures are not only realistic, but they are life-sized, you know, wax figures, and the bodies of these figures and shapes are accurate to the inch of the real person. So when I looked at someone like Bob Marley's waxed sculpture, like up close, it was almost as though Bob's actual body was canonized. You know, it was like, you know, if you've ever been to a Catholic church, you know, the Catholic church is famous for canonizing bodies of people where the church deemed them as, you know, saints. So the only difference was that, you know, they're not encased in glass or anything. You know, it felt just like that. It really freaked me out. Although at the same time, I was extremely fascinated by it. Wow, just go. I really, really recommend it. I mean, if you guys have a bunch of kids and you need to find something to do, you know, to have family time with each other, go to Madame Tussauds. If you are a history buff, you know, like history or music and what's the word I'm looking at, you know, just history in general, go. You'll really enjoy yourself there. So, I hope you guys enjoy the video. I have a lot of footage. I didn't get everybody, you know, just the people that I felt that were interesting and worth being in my camera. Again, I try to get as close as I possibly can down to the hairline. And I tried to get, you know, walk around and get some 3D shots, but I couldn't get it of everybody just because of the way they were positioned. So I couldn't get to the back of all of the wax figures, but I got a good enough footage that you guys can pretty much experience what I've experienced when I was there. So thanks guys for watching and enjoy. See you next time.
No.
the bodies exhibit may understand exactly what I'm talking about. Keep in mind again that these wax figures are not only realistic, but they are life-sized, you know, wax figures, and the bodies of these figures and shapes are accurate to the inch of the real person. So when I looked at someone like Bob Marley's waxed sculpture, like up close, it was almost as though Bob's actual body was canonized. You know, it was like, you know, if you ever been to a Catholic church, you know, the Catholic Church is famous for canonizing bodies of people where the church deemed them as, you know, saints. So the only difference was that, you know, they're not encased in glass or anything. You know, it felt just like that. It really freaked me out, although at the same time I was extremely fascinated by it. Wow, just go. I really, really recommend it. I mean, if you guys have a bunch of kids and you need to find something to do, you know, to have family time with each other, go to Madame Tussauds. If you are a history buff, you know, like history or music and what is the word I'm looking at? You know, just history in general. Go. You'll really enjoy yourself there. So, I hope you guys enjoy the video. I have a lot of footage. I didn't get everybody, you know, just the people that I felt that were interesting and worth being in my camera. Again, I try to get as close as I possibly can down to the hairline. I tried to get, you know, walk around and get some 3D shots, but I couldn't get it of everybody just because of the way they were positioned. So I couldn't get to the back of all of the wax figures, but I got a good enough footage that you guys can pretty much experience what I've experienced. Salutations, everybody, and thank you for watching VintageNewscast.com. I hope everyone is doing well, and I have a very special treat for you today. I want to share with you my experience at the Madame Tussauds House of Wax. I have a lot of footage to show you. It was an amazing experience. Wow, I really did enjoy myself, and I'm very glad I decided to go. My journey started off at the 9th floor, and I walked my way down to, I think, about the 3rd floor. It was like a maze there. When I walked in, you know, you'd never think that the place is so huge, but it is very huge. And when you look up, the ceilings seemed like they go on forever. It was like being in a castle. Now, to my understanding, they had about over 200 plus waxed celebrities and historic figures there. Some of them looked very real. Very real. The detail of these wax figures were phenomenal, down to the hairline. It must have cost thousands and thousands of dollars, literally, just to create one. The artists and the people who sculpted these figures are truly talented. It was well worth visiting Madame Tussauds. Now, some of the figures, in my opinion, didn't look like, some of the wax figures didn't look like the person that they were supposed to represent. For instance, Oprah, in my opinion, did not look like Oprah. Then again, I realized, you know, it may have depended on the year that they sculpted her, because we all know Oprah has changed tremendously throughout her career. But judging how Oprah looks today, thank you. Picture and show it, you know, beside her so you can see what I'm talking about. So, you know, I hope you guys don't think that, you know, I'm crazy. Although I really, really enjoyed myself there, I also felt very weird. Those of you who've been at the bodies exhibit may understand exactly what I'm talking about. Keep in mind again that these wax figures are not only realistic, but they are life-sized, you know, wax figures, and the bodies of these figures and shapes are accurate to the inch of the real person. So, when I looked at someone like Bob Marley's waxed sculpture, like up close, it was almost as though Bob's actual body was canonized. You know, it was like, you know, if you've ever been to a Catholic church, you know, the Catholic Church is famous for canonizing bodies of people where the church deemed them as, you know, saints. So the only difference was that, you know, they're not encased in glass or anything. You know, it felt just like that. It really freaked me out. Although at the same time, I was extremely fascinated by it. Wow. Just go. I really, really recommend it. I mean, if you guys have a bunch of kids and you need to find something to do, you know, to have family time with each other, go to Madame Tussauds. If you are a history buff, you know, like history on music and what is the word I'm looking at, you know, just history in general, go. You'll really enjoy yourself there. So, well, I hope you guys enjoy the video. I have a lot of footage. I didn't get everybody, you know, just the people that I felt that were interesting and worth being in my camera. Again, I try to get as close as I thank you.